Hi everyone and welcome back to the Hair Loss Show. In today's episode, we're going to talk about PRP, but one of the sort of practicalities of how we administer PRP, just to make it more effective for you. So stick around. One of the most common treatments that you'll see being advertised for people that are losing hair is PRP or platelet-rich plasma. And the thing is that there are a lot of clinics offering the service and a lot of systems on the market. Every system will tell you that the quality of the growth factors that they produce are going to be the best. And so every clinic will obviously tell you that they've got the best system and the best results. And that's fine. I mean, I think you can certainly study each system and make an argument for the pros and cons of every system that is on the market. But really, one of the fundamental principles that you cannot take into consideration is you as a patient. What your blood count is, what your platelet count is, will also determine the quality of the actual extract that you're able to remove from the blood. That said, it's not what I want to concentrate on today, but what I want to focus on is actually how we administer the PRP. And I know that a lot of clinics that don't, for example, have a doctor on site will be offering PRP services, and they'll extract the blood from you, they'll spin it down, they'll harvest the platelet-rich component, and they'll inject it back into the scalp. And the understanding being is that, you know, it's actually a small needle, shouldn't hurt too much. There are multiple injections that they have to give, but it's actually a very superficial level. And for most people, that should be fine. Now, the actual act of injecting into the skin also promotes blood flow, promotes an inflammatory component as well, so there could be an advantage there from that perspective. In our clinic, one of the things that we do is that I never do a PRP treatment without doing a ring block, so local anesthetic into the area, because I want to make sure that the patients are feeling comfortable. But I think there's an additional point to consider there as well, because one of the things that we do when we're injecting the local anesthetic, we inject local anesthetic with a little bit of what we call adrenaline. And what the adrenaline does is it helps the blood vessels to constrict, and therefore there's not so much bleeding in the area when you're injecting the PRP subsequently. Now, if we think about it, the advantage of that, or certainly one of the advantages of that, is firstly, there's no pain or less pain when you're injecting the PRP, but also, if the body is not experiencing pain at a cellular level, there's less likely to be bleeding from those injection points where you're injecting the PRP. So if you are injecting the PRP and you're getting some bleeding at that site, then there is a risk that the bleeding is also pushing out any of the injectable PRP that you've injected into that area out as well. So it does bring into question, well, actually, how much is in the area that you've injected? So I think that also factors into our decision as to why we always do a ring block when we're administrating PRP. So just something to think about, because I know there are a lot of clinics that offer PRP services that say you don't need to have local anesthetic, it's perfectly fine. And yeah, there's an argument for that, but this is the reason why we use a local anesthetic ring block. Hope that helps. Thanks very much for sticking around. We'll speak to you on the next episode.